I Mary Jones. What a girl, what a world, what a light. Oh, I Mary Jones. What a fine, loving, blind, what a wife. Do he and gay all day she keeps my heart laughing, never know where her brain has flown. Each his own. Can he not ask why I Mary Jones?
The Joan Davis Show. I Married Joan, America's favorite comedy show, starring America's queen of comedy, Joan Davis, as Mrs. Joan Stevens. And featuring Jim Backus as Judge Bradley Stevens.
Johnny, that's the third time you've done that today.
I'm just lucky, I guess.
Well, you sure bought out the store, Mabel.
Well, an awful lot of people are coming to my birthday party, and I want to make sure there's enough.
Oh, you sure like big birthdays. By the way, how old are you going to be this year?
Oh, I don't mind telling you. Just exactly a year younger than you.
Why, you old... You kid, you.
Oh, don't let's forget what I stopped by here for, your orange cake recipe.
No, I got it in the kitchen, honey.
You make the best orange cake I ever tasted. I want to use the recipe for my birthday cake.
Honey, just for that, I'll bake it for you.
Why, Jonah, you doll. You absolute living doll.
All right.
And just because you're so sweet, I have a confession to make. I'm really not a year younger than you. I'm a year older than you.
Oh, you're a year older.
Uh-huh.
Gee, Mabel, now you can vote this year. Oh, boy. What's this?
What's what?
Oh, this great big gift box. And look how beautifully it's packed.
What is it?
Huh? Well, I don't know, but we'll soon find out. It's got a card in it. For my darling wife. Is that Brad the sweetest man in the whole world? Is he an angel?
I wonder what it is.
So do I.
Well, you don't have to remain in suspense. Open it up.
Oh, no. Brad wants to be here when I open it. That's why he hid it in the closet.
Well, from the size and shape of it, it could be almost anything at all.
No, I couldn't deprive Brad of that pleasure.
A sweet guy like Brad wouldn't want you to die of curiosity. Besides...
Okay, you talk me into it, Mabel. Really wrapped it.
What a gorgeous card, huh? How about that address?
Well, how about that bread? I'm going to try it on this very minute.
What about spoiling Brad's surprise?
Oh, honey, I'll put it back in the box and rewrap it, and you'll never know the difference. Come on.
Wait a minute. I got to step back where it belongs. Say, by the way, Joan, what's the occasion?
Occasion?
Yeah, for Brad buying you the dress.
Are you kidding? Brad doesn't need an occasion to buy me a gift. That's how he is. That's all.
Gee.
It's always nice to get gifts on birthdays or anniversaries or at Christmas, but this is the greatest thrill, to get a gift for the sheer joy of giving. That's my lover, Brad.
Tomorrow's my birthday, and Charlie hasn't even mentioned it. That's my stinker, Charlie. Oh, well, I guess some men are just naturally thoughtful and some aren't. Joan, I've never seen anything so beautiful in my whole life.
Thanks. The dress is nice, too.
Nice? It's simply gorgeous. Oh, Brad has wonderful taste.
Oh, for a man.
Well, all I can say is I wish Charlie bought me a dress like that.
I guess Brad didn't notice this big bow. He doesn't usually like clothes that are too elaborate.
But, Joan, that's the beautiful feature of this.
No, I better take it off, Mabel.
But, Joan, the bow was put there to balance the big ruffle.
Oh, you're right, Mabel. I better take the ruffle off, too, because Brad will like it so much better without all the frills on it, believe me.
But, Joan, that's the beautiful part of the dress. You're just ruining it. Poor Brad, he'll feel terrible. And besides, it just won't be the same dress he brought you anymore.
Don't be silly, Mabel. Now, you know how a man buys a dress. Some sales girl probably talked him into it. Some slick chick with a real line of talk. I'll bet she rolled her eyes at him. Ooh, if I ever get my hands on that one.
I just don't think you're being fair to Brad.
Oh, don't be silly, Mabel. Now, I can make this dress look much better. Really, I can. Then I'll put it back in the box, and when Brad gives it to me, he'll never know the difference.
But, Joan...
Oh, I've done it before, dear. Brad always likes me best in short sleeves.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes, dear.
Johnny, please!
Now, listen, Mabel. On your dress, you can change what you like, and on my dress, I can change what I like, okay?
Oh, Johnny, honestly, I just can't bear to watch it anymore.
Oh, you're silly. This is going to look much, much better on me. I'll get that all the way.
Oh, how can you ruin a beautiful dress like that? I've never seen one.
I wonder how this would look strapless. That's it.
Those chairs are sure going to come in handy, Brad.
Oh, look at those boxes. The girls must be home.
Yeah. They're in the bedroom. Come on. Johnny.
Oh, Brad, I didn't watch it.
Oh, no, that's the dress I bought you, Mabel, for your birthday. What happened to it? It's all cut up.
The dress you bought for me?
I left it here with Brad.
She told me it was her dress. She cut it all off. It was so beautiful.
Mabel. Joni, surely you can explain this.
Well, of course I can explain, dear. You see, the dress that you bought, I thought, for me, and they had a card on it. It's the card, that's what did the card. And I thought that I was the wife and you were the darling. And
oh, my.
That Mabel. I can't get over the way she acted, making all that fuss about the dress. After all, I didn't do it on purpose. How was I to know it was her dress?
Uh-huh.
Well, nobody can say the things that she said to me. Nobody.
Well, will you please forget about Mabel and let's go to sleep?
Tell you this, nobody. Boy, my eyes are finally open to that Mabel. Why, she could get down on her hands and knees to me now, and I wouldn't talk to her. Who does she think she is, after all the things that I've done?
Look, Joni, will you please forget about Mabel, honey, and let's go to sleep.
All right, dear. And the favors that I have done.
Joni, I have to get... I work, you know. I... Darling.
Good night, dear. I used to get her dates before she was married. I'm the one that introduced her to Charlie.
Joni, please, I agree with you. Mabel is no good. She treated you very badly. She has no character. She's a miserable person. Okay?
I don't think you ought to say those things about Mabel. After all, she is my dearest friend.
Joni, for goodness sakes.
I think I ought to be big about this. Give her a chance to apologize, don't you, Brad?
Well, yes, let's discuss it tomorrow, huh?
No, honey, Mabel probably is in tears for the things that she said to me, and I know she just won't enjoy her party unless I'm there. She's probably dying to tell me how sorry she is.
Oh, sure.
I'm going to call her up.
At this hour?
I know Mabel, dear, and she's very worried.
But
no, this is the best thing I could do. Sounds like nobody's home.
Yeah.
Hello, Mabel? Did I wake you up? Oh, I'm sorry. This is Joan. Hello? Hello?
She hung up on you, huh?
Now I won't accept her apology. Why, who needs her party? I wouldn't go now if she begged me. Nothing she says or does now will make any difference. I am through with her forever. Oh, the dishes are done. The kitchen's all cleaned up.
Oh, good, dear.
Weather clear, bright? Mabel's having nice weather for her party.
Having a party right now. Listen to him.
Oh, boy, it's good to stay home for a change, isn't it?
It certainly is. Gives you a chance to relax, you know. Take it easy.
Yeah. We've been doing much too much running around lately. We got to stay home more.
Yeah. Gives you a chance to relax. Take it easy.
Oh, boy, it's so cozy, just the two of us.
Cozy is the word.
No. Well, this is a good time to catch up on our reading, Dad.
Oh, yes, it seems we never have much time to read.
Nice, isn't it? Believe you me, this is so much better than getting all dressed up in front of a lot of people, you know, your best behavior.
Oh, listen, there's no comparison. There's nothing like a nice, quiet evening at home.
Mabel and her party. Brad.
What is
it? I was thinking, why don't we call up a few friends of our own and have a party tonight? I'll bake one of my orange cakes.
Oh, that's a wonderful idea. I'll get the list and I'll start calling the people.
Good, and I'll start baking. Happy party to me. Happy party to me.
Yeah. Oh, yes, that's quite all right some other time. Well, everybody we seem to know is going to Mabel's party. So I guess we won't have a party after all.
Did you call Mr. and Mrs. Cregan?
Oh, honey, he's the biggest bore in the world.
Oh, I know, dear, but they never get invited anyplace. They don't go out much.
Well, I guess I could laugh at his jokes for one more night.
Yeah, it'll be a blessing. I'll tidy up, dear.
Hello? Oh, may I speak to Mr. or Mrs. Cregan? Oh, they went to Mabel's party. What are you doing tonight? Oh, you're the sitter. You've got to stay there. All right. Thank you. Goodbye. Well, dear, that's that.
I just thought of somebody, dear.
Well, who is it?
You don't know him, dear.
No?
There it is. You tidy up, honey. Oh. But Mabel hasn't tied up all the interesting people in town. By a long shot. Hello, Tubby Richards. Well, I don't know whether you remember me or not, but I used to sit behind you in the third grade. Skinny girl with freckles. What do I look like now? Well, I'm blonde, not so skinny. I'm married. Hello? Tubby Richards. He hasn't changed since the third grade.
Well, there goes the party. Then you can forget about the cake, too.
No, dear. We're going to have a party by ourselves. Just the two of us.
What, dear?
Wait till you see, dear.
Tony, what is that?
It's stuff left over from our New Year's Eve party from the women's club.
Oh,
we're going to have fun, Brad. Just you and I. You see all this stuff.
Oh, come
look,
on.
Dear. That?
Paper.
How about me?
Huh? Oh, that's the spirit. Who needs Mabel in her old party?
You said it. Whoopee!
Yahoo!
Well, that was fun. Now we're leaving. I know. Let's dance.
Oh, that's a good idea. You go turn on the radio.
Okay, dear.
May I have this dance, Mrs. Stevens?
Of course, Mr. Stevens. You may call me Joan.
Thanks, and you may call me Brad.
Thank you. I'm going to tell you the truth, Brad. I haven't danced for a long time. I'm kind of tired.
Oh, I'm kind of bush myself.
What do you say we set this one out?
All right.
I'm having fun. fun, aren't you?
Oh, yes, yes, I certainly am.
Whoopee.
Yahoo! Game time.
What?
Well, we can't have a party without playing games, dear.
Just a...
We're going to play spin the bottle.
Oh, and I'll bet I get to kiss the prettiest girl in the whole room.
Oh, you. You old playboy, you. Go on, spin first, dear.
All right, here we go. Wow.
Me!
Oh,
how is that?
Oh. Now, you spin.
Me?
Yes, you spin.
Yes!
Lucky!
You want to go around again? Whoopee!
Yahoo!
Oh, Brad, we need some life in this party.
Life? Is that what you... Oh, ho! I am the life of the party!
What you gonna do, honey?
Look at me! I'm a 60-watt bulb!
Oh, Brad, you are the funny... Well, oh, that reminds me of a funny story.
About a light bulb?
No, about a barber shop.
Well, come on, honey. Tell it to me. Come on.
Oh, you want to hear it?
Sure.
Well, this fella, you see, he's had one too many kids. And he's sitting in the barber chair like this, all slumped over. He says to the barber, he says, "Barber, give me a shave, will you?" And the barber says, "Well, mister, if you want to shave, you'll have to hold your head up." He says, "Oh, in that case, give me a haircut."
That is the funniest story that I've ever...
You should have heard the girl scream at the club when Mabel... Mabel.
It's funny.
Oh, well.
The barber.
Whoopee.
Yahoo.
Come here. Oh.
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. I thought I wasn't. Well, I guess this party is kind of a flop, you know.
Yeah. Well, nothing can go wrong with my orange cake. Let's have some of that, dear.
Well, I guess we can always have some of that. Yeah.
It's all cool and ready, dear.
Huh? Boy, that looks great.
Icing on it, dear, and...
Oh, Joni, look, I got butter on my sleeve.
Now, how did you do... Oh, for heaven's sakes, I better get it out before it dries. Oh, my. Honey, honey, oh, put the match out. This stuff is highly inflammable. I really don't know how you do those things.
I just passed.
Dear, when you get in the kitchen, you've got to be more careful. There's no stuff there.
Thank you, dear.
It's out. What do you mean it, Brad? Gee. Now, now for the icing, dear.
Oh, boy, I can hardly wait to eat it.
You wait, honey, and I'll cut you a nice big slice.
Okay, honey, but you know how I love your orange cake.
Well, this time it's going to be even better. A new ingredient's been added.
Something new?
Walnuts.
Oh.
I was going to surprise you. Wait a minute. I know how to go to Mabel's party and be received with open arms.
How?
Well, I'll make this a birthday cake for her.
Yes.
All I have to do is write happy birthday. Oh, oh Brad.
Hey.
Oh, Mabel will feel a lot different about me when she tastes this cake. Hi, Mabel.
Joan. What are you doing here?
I brought you a birthday cake. Look. I baked it myself. It's my orange cake.
I'm sorry, Mabel. Happy birthday, Joan. Well, I must say it was very sweet of you, Joan.
It has some special secret ingredients in it.
Am I forgiven, Mabel?
Oh, I can't be angry at you. Come in. You all know the Stevenses, Joan and Brad.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, Cregan. Oh, Brad. Oh, the Cregan.
Let me take your stole, darling.
Thanks.
Now, look here, Brad.
Oh, Charlie, why don't you shake hands and make up with Brad? Mabel and I did.
Well,
come on.
Well, all right, Charlie.
Well, I'm glad to have you here.
Yeah.
Everybody, come on, everybody, gather around. I want you all to have a piece of the birthday cake Joni baked for me.
Wait a minute, honey, you forgot to light the candle.
Come on, folks. I promise you one taste of this cake and you'll never forget it.
Oh, it's not that good.
Now, don't be modest, dear. You know your orange cake is dynamite.
It sure is.
I seem to smell cleaning fluid.
Oh, that's from my sleeve. I spilled a little.
Boy, it's really powerful, Brad.
Hey, look, we want to eat some of this cake. Come on and blow out the candle.
Oh, okay.
Wait, honey. You forgot to make a wish.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. Okay.
This chance only comes once a year, dear. Make it a good one.
Yeah, maybe I ought to change it. Okay, this is it.
Wait a minute, honey. Why don't you tell us all what your wish is?
All right. I wish the best of everything for my best friend, Joan.
Oh,
and I wish that 50 years from today, she and I will be as good friends as we are right now. And that on my birthday, she'll bake me the same kind of cake she baked for me today. Now I'll blow out the candle.
Wait, honey. What do you say we all sing happy birthday to good old Mae?
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mabel.
Mabel kicking us out of her house. Well, I guess that ends my friendship with her.
And I'm finished with Charlie.
I'm glad I forgot to give her a birthday present I bought her, too.
What is it?
Oh, it's a book on home gardening. She's crazy about the subject. But the nerve of that woman saying that I purposely brought that exploding birthday cake to her party. How ridiculous can you get?
Well, Charlie was just as bad. I couldn't make that stubborn mule realize it was just an accident.
Well, I say good riddance to both of them.
And so do I.
Joan!
Mabel!
Darling, Charlie and I talked it over. We realized you were right. The cake must have been an accident.
Sure, you're our friend. You wouldn't do anything like that.
Well, of course not. I wouldn't insult a friend for the world.
As a matter of fact, Joni was more frightened than anyone when it happened.
That's the first birthday cake I ever saw that blew out its own candle.
Oh, that's Joni, boy. Always some excitement when she's around.
Good old Joni.
Oh, say, Mabel, in the excitement, I forgot your birthday present.
Oh, Joni, you shouldn't have.
Oh, what do you mean, Mabel? You know, when I saw this, I said, now, this is for Mabel. This is just for her.
Oh, how to be happy, though fat. Well, all of us. Come on, Charlie.
Wait! They must have wrapped the wrong book. It was a mistake.
The only mistake was my coming here to forgive you.
You can say that again. Come on, let's go. Oh,
but they wrapped it wrong, and it was a mistake. You believe me, don't you, Brad?
Oh, sure I do. That, Mabel, what an unreasonable woman. How a person with normal intelligence can get angry just because you bought a book called How to Be Happy Though Fat. It takes a real idiot to do that.
Of course. I bought it for you, Brad.
Me? Why of all the insulting? How to be happy though fat? Charlie, Mabel, wait for me!
Happy birthday to you.
I'm Mary Jones. What a girl, what a world, what a night. Oh, I'm Mary Jones. What a mind, love is blind, what a wife. Giddy and gay all day, she keeps my heart laughing. Never know where her brain has gone. To reach his own. Can't deny that's why I'm Mary Jones. To reach his own, can't deny that's why I'm very joyful.